Administrators busy, but the bird. state.
Oh, thank you, Scotty.
Yes, the next one out of town.
If only you would let me sing a few baritones and baritone roles, I would gladly shoulder even more of the administrative burden.
You know very well, if I let you sing with the opera company, it would go straight to your head, and you'd lose all interest in office admin, and I can't afford it. Besides, the world is full of basic baritones.
Basic baritones!
But your singing has given me an idea. I must say this one season, how to take opera back to its roots, back to text. I'll commission a series of plays without any singers. No singing!
No singing. No singing. Scotty, this is an opera company. I think the Minister for the Arts and indeed the public might expect some art.
Singing! I suppose so! We've done popular operas to death. Year after year, we trot out the same tired old productions of the same classic FM-friendly composers. I want to do something unusual. But to put on a new production of an opera is just so dang expensive.
That may have been true in the past, but if you're clever, opera can be produced really quite economically.
Really? Mm-hmm. What about the lavish costumes, the epic scenery, the bulky orchestra, the bloody nauseating chorus?
Nothing simpler. Announce that you're going to do opera in the raw.
What, Nick?
In a sense, yes. To promote the utmost realism, set everything in modern dress. Get the costumes on the op shop. No need for extravagant costumes.
And no wigs!
I'm not ready to be.
Neither am I.
Benefactor.
And where am I going to find
I present Mr. Angel.
Mr. Angel.
Right. Where'd you got the job again? Now I've a rattle in sight. You artist. What a life. I don't know why you get paid at all. You should be paying us. I expect you're wondering why I'm here. So happens I need your help. How can I be of service, Mr. Angel?
Oh, call me Alan.
What can I do for you, Mr.
Alan?
Quite a lot, Scotty. Quite a lot. We're both men of the world.
World.
And of business.
Business.
I won't beat around the bush.
Bush.
I'll get straight to the point.
He's getting to the point.
Thank you. You may or may not be aware that for some time I have been... That I have been... That Goldie and I have been... Goldie?
Dame Gwendolyn Goldentrill.
Not the Dame Goldentrill. I remember her debut at Covent Garden. Magnificent!
Stupendous!
Ferocious!
Hasn't she retired?
Yes! And no, if you take my name... Confidentially, I hoped that the five-star lifestyle I provided would help her forget the stage. But I think she's bored. And between you and me, she's turned into a right bitch. I can't handle it anymore. You've got to help me get her back onto the stage.
So, you've been boring her, have you? Well, the truth is, Mr. Angel, that although we would love to engage a singer of Dame Goldentrill's caliber, the roles she is renowned for and presumably would expect to sing are not in our usual repertoire.
And budget requirements would be significant.
Look, it'll be worth a great deal to me. Say, 2 million?
Million?
Would that accommodate some of the associated budgetary requirements? All right, make it 3. What's a mil between mates, eh? Now let's get down to business. Goldie realises you might want to hear a sing, after all.
Oh, yeah, indeed. Malicious tongues are saying that the voice is not as much as gossip, of course.
She wants to audition for you. Now, today.
What a singer singing in my office. I'm afraid that would be impossible.
Because the acoustic of this room is hardly suitable for an artist of Dame Goldentrill's calibre. However, if she would be happy to overlook this, Mr. Angel will be delighted to hear her.
Robert! I'm gonna get her!
We were totally insane! Do we have to declare this?
Don't worry.
I think we told you this, our boy. And make sure you do. Remember the Essendon Football Club. What happened in the locker room certainly didn't stay in the locker room.
But with this money, we could put on a season of old favourites starring Dame Goldentrill, which will sell out. And then you can indulge your own fantasy and put on artistic productions of obscure, lost operas that no one wants to hear.
My principles, my ideals, my reputation.
The source of the money is not important, only the purpose to which it is put. Werner Church is built on the offerings of sinners.
I would rather deal with sinners than singers any day.
Please, let me go to my winery before she arrives. Too late. She can't. wondering if it might not be possible to induce you to lend lustre to our season.
Of course he was. And who, may I ask you?
This is my assistant, your greatest fan, Mr. Basil Bluff.
Your assistant? Quel dommage. I thought you might be a singer. You're so tall and distinguished. You'd make an alluring figure on the stage.
Oh, thank you, madam. Actually, I'm a professional baritone in the waiting. Maybe have a photo together?
Prepared
since the offer.
My dear fellow.
My dear fellow, you've got it all wrong.
I only want to help. We at FU Mining believe that everybody's entitled to opera, and I just want to give it to them.
You see, Scotty?
Of course, I shall expect a little bit of a say in the artistic policy of the company.
Yeah, you see, Basil,
I've always fancied myself as an impresario, and I think you'll find I've got some pretty groundbreaking ideas. Let's get rid of all those boring old operas and do a really sexy one, like My Fair Lady. It's a musical! The business basis is my speciality. I've got no time for art or music, but I understand merchandising, and I know what people like. Stuff like Oklahoma!
Oh, what a beautiful morning!
Oklahoma fucking Homer! But getting back to business, Sylvie's waiting downstairs in the limo, and I want to bring her up so you can cop an eyeful of her talent.
She's waiting in the limo with Madame Goldentrill. You amaze me, Mr. Angel. You could give us all lessons.
Matt, you've got to be kidding. They've each got their own car and their own bloody everything else besides. I'll be right back.
Well, Scotty, you must admit our prospects are looking considerably brighter. An hour ago we had no money at all, and now we have a cool $3.5 million and in the bank, and plenty more that came from.
But to be honest, it's making my winery looking more attractive. This whole enterprise is looking less like an opera company and more like one of Clive Palmer's companies. I suppose, now that we have all that money, you'll be asking for a rent.
Scotty, how could you think I could take advantage of being your right-hand man at a time like this? That would be completely unethical. However, we could perhaps augment my income by assigning me some suitable baritone roles.
I thought we were friends, Basil. You know how I feel about singers. I just can't stand them!
And
keep the eyes off of me, then.
That's it. You know, Mr. Angel, I was most favourably impressed. Miss Silverpeal, despite your lack of experience, we would like to offer you a contract. We will assign you small roles to begin with and pay you the full equity wage of $1,200 a week.
Small roles? $1,200 a week? I have never been so insulted. I am a winner of Slovenia's Got Talent. You will make it in your particular opera company. You will have to give me all the romantic names. Christine, Cosette, Maria. $6,000 a week, and to pay for personal stylist.
Well, yes, you could do with a personal stylist.
I already have a stylist. I don't want you to pay for her.
You don't need a stylist, my dear. I love you just the way you are, the natural look. But I will try to persuade my good friend Scotty here to give you $6,000 a week and all the romantic leads.
Like, darling, some of us can sing.
$5 a week. Give you both star billing and print your names bigger than the composer and the conductor combined.
Thank you.
teaching and now long lunches.
But this is an opera company.
And no fraternising. Sorry, girls, it's over. Put your egos aside and start practising.
Oh, this is just like an opera.
I will practice night and day, be content with whatever roles you assign to me, and still be very happy to continue working in a managerial role.
Thanks, mate. Near luck you can on you.
Alan, shall we?
Yes, Nadine?